What's up, everybody? It's Enes here. Welcome to another episode. This week, we're in the famed Bourge Street of Hollywood Hills and about to tour this newly constructed sunny contemporary home. This home was built by Dugali Oberfeld, designed by Zoltan Pally. It gets amazing views of the city and it has phenomenal architecture, so I'm really excited for today's episode. Now, specs of this home. We got 6 bedrooms, 8 bathrooms, 11,583 square feet of interior space, built on a 25,440 square foot lot, and this property is currently on the market for $34 million. As always, we will leave more information about the property down in the description. And before we start our tour, I want to thank the listing agents, Mauricio Umansky, James Harris, and David Parnes for allowing us to tour their amazing listing. Now let's begin. From the street level, we have the gate opening up to this driveway that leads us to the covered carport. The lower floor of this home is built out of board from concrete walls. You can actually see the holes for the steel rods. And as we go this way, we have the mechanic room on the left, 2 doors that opens up to the storage, and this door actually opens up to the lower level of this home. And another detail I would like to point out are these recessed in areas where we have the plate covers and the outlets. I just thought that was a cool detail. Now, before we take the stairs and talk about the entry, I want to go back here and talk about the exterior architecture of this home. We have the board from concrete walls on the subterranean level, and the second floor consists of these bronze slats that wraps around the entire property. We have this cantilever design, which we're going to tour on the backyard. Overall, it's a beautiful contemporary architecture. And as we come up these stairs, we have these steel case planters on this side, another staircase taking you to the backyard from this point. And the house is nicely separated from the street level with these board from concrete walls. Now, we're at the entry. We have a secondary gate here, and this walkway takes you to the main entry. As you come up here, we have a water feature on the right-hand side, and these white stairs are leading you towards the entry. Before I go in, this is really unique. They have a secondary door right here that closes off this entry, and the main pivot door right here. Let's go inside. All right, everyone, here we are at the entry. I really like the glass lid that this pivot door has. And as soon as you walk in, you see amazing views and this glass walkway that takes you to the lower level. But before we talk about that, why don't we go to the right first and check out the first room, which is the office. We have the built-in bookshelves on our right-hand side, desk setup right here. This is a front-facing room, massive picture window here, looking towards the downtown Los Angeles views. And to match the exterior clad, they have the bronze screens also here. Now, Mikey, can we get a close-up? There's a really unique detail I would like to point out. So we have this glass door opening up to the backside of the property where we have the skylights running the entire length of this property. And we're gonna show where these skylights are bringing natural light once we go down to the lower level. Now, let's go back out to the hallway and go to the other side, because this hallway takes us to the powder room for this floor. Beautiful marble floors, and they use the same marble to clad the back wall. Floating vanity design here with a marble vessel sink. It looks gorgeous. We also have chrome wall fixtures, another sliding glass door opening up to the back of the property. Now, let's go back to the atrium, the entry, and talk about this massive opening. They use frosted glass, which allows natural light from the skylight above us to go down to the lower level as well. And they use steel to pretty much frame this entire staircase and this massive opening right here. And we have more of these openings with these sky bridges, letting natural light into the lower level as well. This sky bridge here connects to the guest suite. The other one connects to the primary bedroom. Now, what's so cool and unique about this home is right above us. This is a 60-foot retractable dimmable skylight, which is amazing. Del, can we hit it?
This is the really, really special feature of this home.
Absolutely. This is a truly vented atrium. And pulling off a detail like this is definitely not easy. Big congrats to the architect and the developer. On a residential project, this is incredible. Now it allows so much natural light and fresh air to come into this property.
Yeah, it's really cool. Also, I heard you say this, but I feel like we need to mention it. It's actually dimmable. So
yes.
Around the corner from me, there's a little switch, and you can actually change the intensity of the glass. So right now you see it's very blue. You can turn it down and it will get, basically that blueness will vanish and all this natural light will come in. Right now it's like on its highest intensity setting, so it's dimming all that light coming in. It's really cool.
I know. I feel like we've been here for a while, but like this skylight assembly, you know, how to waterproof this, how to pull it off. This is such a challenge. I mean, it's incredible that they pulled it off.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, now the first sky bridge takes us to the first guest suite on this level. It's very spacious. Same glass doors that we saw in the office is also here, again, opening up to the back of the property. And right around the corner, we have a full bathroom with a walk-in shower. Now, let's go back out. And before we continue this way, I wanna take you guys to the family room. Oak panel walls on this side, built-in bookshelf, TV setup right here, this amazing corner glass detail. From your couch, you look at downtown Los Angeles and Hollywood Hills. That's actually Sunset Plaza Drive right there. Amazing, amazing open space. And we have walls of glass right here looking towards the entire city and the backyard. Couple things I would like to mention here. So we have these steel columns that are throughout this level of the home, and they're 20 feet apart from each other. So each one of these openings are 20 feet. And we have these glass doors, again, stacking on each side, kind of opening this floor to the backyard. Amazing views. And as we continue the family room, we have the main kitchen right here. Darker tone cabinets complemented with the natural stone countertops. We have this massive island design right here with the bar seating. This kitchen is very sleek. And as we go in, we have the paneled fridge and freezer here. More cabinets on the island. Mikey, can we get a close up? We have the first dishwasher right here with a little bit of a push. There you go. Skaganow. Main sink. You get amazing, amazing views from your kitchen. And as we continue, more base cabinets, seam natural stone used as a backsplash, induction cooktop, and they actually left the top of the cabinets open, so it's not actually going all the way up to the ceiling to allow natural light to travel through the entire room. More cabinets, we have the built-in appliances here. This is a cool detail. Dumbwaiter that actually goes down to the lower level where we have the secondary kitchen for this house. That kitchen is just as impressive as this one. And lastly, Mikey, can we get a close-up? These cabinets are built by Polyform, and look at these drawers, how nicely they're dressed. This is amazing, right?
I love a well-organized drawer.
I mean, I love it, I love it. Overall, very sleek kitchen design. And kitchen is kind of separated from the dining area with this built-in kind of open shelving. And right in front of us, we have the dining area. It is situated between the formal living room area and the kitchen, table for eight, beautiful chandelier above. And even from here, you enjoy the amazing views. Now, before we go to the formal living room area, why don't we take the second sky bridge and check out the primary bedroom suite. And it starts right here. This door opens up to this hallway that takes you to the bedroom. Room gets a ton of natural light. We have the king size bed situated on this side. Beautiful hardwood floors complemented with this oak panel back wall. And right here we have the floor to ceiling glass doors that are automatic. And they also have automatic shades and blackouts as well. And they open up to this patio space on the side of the property. Recessed in bookshelves right here with LED lighting. And there's one more detail here I would like to talk about. There's actually two more now that I'm looking towards the views as well. Number one, from your bed, you get amazing views of the hills, city, all the way to the ocean. And second detail is when I had a chance to talk to the architect, like I mentioned earlier, the wall behind the bed is actually not connected to the exterior wall. That allows this room to have one entry point and another entry or exit point as well. It makes the room feel a little bit more spacious. And instead of having a door jam and kind of a door here, architect just puts another pocket door. There you go. Now, this door opens up to the primary bathroom. This bathroom is simply stunning. We have double vanities, two water closets, beautiful walk-in shower, same hardwood floors also continues here. Right-hand side, we have these sliding glass doors opening up to the back of the property. And let's start with this vanity right here. Floating design, Corian countertops, beautiful marble back wall. Mikey, let's get a close-up here. First water closet, beautifully clad with marble. It's bookmatched also. And check this out. Same marble actually continues into the walk-in shower. Again, it's bookmatched right in the center. Also on the floors. Never seen this detail before. Look at the drain lines. They're super sleek and they kind of have this triangle design as well. I feel like we're used to seeing those square ones. So that's unique because there's actually a lot of these triangle patterns in this house. Talking about patterns, take a look at this shampoonage. How they carved in all those triangle designs with a CNC machine. But what's so amazing about this design is they left the veins untouched. They also have these LED lightings that highlights these patterns a little bit more. And right above us, two rain heads, handhelds, beautiful skylight above, bringing natural light to this walk-in shower. I mean, simply stunning. Now, Mikey, let's get out because there's two more things I would like to show to you. Number one, second water closet is here, just like the other side. Beautiful Toto toilet, fancy one, of course. Marble walls. Do you see the patterns also on these little shelves as well?
Yeah, it's really nice.
There's one more place. Let's get out. Second vanity is on this side, same design. Now let's get a close up to this marble as well. They did the same pattern also here. How cool is that?
Yeah, it's kind of hard to see on my camera, but they are definitely there.
Yeah, it's definitely a unique detail. Now, as we go through this opening, we have the primary closet here. Before we go in there, these door jambs are also nicely clad with the same bronze slats that we saw on the exterior of the home, tying the overall architecture. I wanted to mention that as well before we tour the closet. Now, this closet is amazing. Again, all polyform cabinets, LED lighting inside of every single cabinet. Mikey, let's get a close up on a couple of these. Look how beautifully dressed each one of these are. Drawers, I mean, the quality of the cabinetry is simply amazing. It wraps around the entire room. Massive skylight right in the center. And they have this detail throughout, you know, a couple places in the house as well. These recessed and tracked LED lighting that kind of gives you that cove lighting detail. And skylights, island setup right here, very spacious, and you get a makeup area on this side. Now, let's go back to the hallway and tour the formal living room area. And this room is all about the amazing views. We have the seating area right in the center, walls of glass, and let's talk about some details here. Number one, the grout line on these limestone floors actually hits these steel columns perfectly right in the center. So floors are pretty much perfectly proportioned throughout the entire level. Second detail, these steel columns look amazing because they grinded all the imperfections, they put Bondo, they sanded, and they painted, so it looks this perfect. I wanted to mention that. Now, this is a very spacious seating area. Again, focused towards amazing views. Ceilings have these track lights that are recessed in. Beautiful flat plane roof line. And now, let's go check out the outside. So we have these steel glass doors. I'm gonna open this section only. And these are, like I mentioned earlier, 20-foot openings. Another detail I really like is the bronze finish on these doors. I feel like we're used to seeing the aluminum or black trim. Because we have bronze cladding throughout, glass doors also match that, so I wanted to point that out. Now, same limestone floors are actually brought to the exterior, but they have different finish. They have this crepey finish. And let's talk about this overhang design, the cantilever. It's a really unique architectural detail of this home. And they accomplished this look by using a lot of steel columns and steel beams. You guys can actually see the I-beams on the inside. It's definitely a unique detail that sets this home apart from the rest of the moderns that we have seen. So I wanted to mention that. And as we continue, outdoor dining area, amazing, amazing views. On the left-hand side, we see downtown Los Angeles, this whole city, all the way to the ocean. I mean, it's amazing. We're at the Burr Streets. Now, let's talk about this 106-foot above ground infinity edge pool. This pool is stunning. They clad the exterior of the pool with this black tile, and we have black plaster on the inside, so it looks like a sheet of glass almost. Right in the center, we have the spa. I don't know if you guys can see it, but spa is about an inch taller than the rest of the pool. They designed it that way, so there's a little bit of a heat separation between the spa and the rest of the pool. Baja shelf over here with some seating. Infinity edge on the other side. I mean, it's simply stunning. Mikey, let's walk to the other side. Also, between the house and the infinity edge pool, we kind of have this AstroTurf section. They utilize the lot extremely well by pushing the pool to the left, kind of leaving this flat section in the middle and having the house on the back. Also, outdoor patio continues. We kind of have this lower section right here. This is actually a fire pit. From here, you can enjoy the amazing views as well. I mean, Mikey, what do you think? This pool, this backyard, the views, this amazing cantilever design. I feel like there's so much to talk about this home.
It's pretty amazing. It's been a long time since we've been up in the hills, especially the Bird Streets, over a year. And I feel like this is just such an iconic design. It's really talked about right now in LA, and I'm really glad we got the chance to come up here and tour. It's so nice.
Absolutely, absolutely. You actually touched on another good point. We are in the Bird Streets, and Bird Streets is like Truesdale of Hollywood Hills. It's a planned development. We have white streets, utilities are buried underground. You get amazing, amazing views. There's an architectural committee. It's definitely one of the best parts of Hollywood Hills. Now, let's continue and let's take the stairs here. And this opens up to the side of the property. That's actually the primary bedroom suite that we just toured. And while we are here, there's one more detail I want to talk about. This might be hard to understand from this angle, but the outline of this home is in the shape of a bird. Architect wanted to go this direction because we're in the Bird Streets. And if you guys look at the overhang design or the edges of the home, it actually kicks out. And the center of the home where we have the atrium is actually pushed in. Again, this is the core of the bird, and the right and the left-hand side are the wings of the bird. So I wanted to mention that because I thought this was such a cool detail. With that, we're pretty much done on the top floor. Now let's go downstairs and check out all the rooms. Everyone, here we are at the lower level, two-story ceilings. Skylight is bringing a ton of natural light to this level as well, and we have polished concrete floors here. Now, before I start talking about this level, I want to turn back and talk about the steel staircase design. We have a beautiful steel frame all around the second floor, and the same steel frame actually continues here as a staircase. It has glass railing and glass threads, open riser, beautiful modern design, and it brings you down to the landing of the lower floor. Now, staircase is complemented with these oak panels with this really cool design. We have the triangle patterns here with smaller and bigger triangles. Some of them are actually a little bit more shallow, and some of them actually has these glass panels on the back because we have some rooms behind this wall as well, which we're going to tour in a bit.
Yeah, and it kind of matches the etching we saw in the primary bathroom, right?
That is correct. Yeah. That is correct. Now, going through here, this door opens up to the powder room for this floor. Same concrete floors are also brought in here. Walls are clad with tile, and we have a floating vanity design. Now, next door right here goes into your, I wanna say, first spa. We have a massage table here, vessel sink. I really like the glazed tile mosaic design on the back of the wall there. And Mikey, we need to get a close up here. This is really cool. So this is a quartz washing table, right? I've never seen one of these before. It has infrared heating, and when you're laying down here washing yourself or someone is washing you, it even has these intricate built-in drain designs here. Looks super cool.
I've been on this earth for 31 years. I've never heard of a washing table.
I've never seen one of these before. The first time I saw them, I couldn't believe it has these built-in drains. I was like, this is super unique.
I guess this whole room, you can get this room like really as wet as you want on the floors because it has drains everywhere, right?
Exactly. Actually, Mikey, why don't you come this side, because I want to show these handhelds here. So you have everything. And of course it has drains around because I'm assuming you'll probably splash out a little bit.
Yeah.
So we have that, and it continues into this walk-in shower. It's all open. Shampoo and itch, and they use the same bronze clad that we saw on the exterior into these shampoo and itch. We're going to see this detail throughout. And talking about those glass panels, we have the oak walls behind this glass insert right here.
That looks really cool.
It is really cool. Now, going back out, we have these mosaic patterns behind the sink here where we have the cabinets, and they carried out the same pattern on these doors as well. That door leads to the mechanical room. And before we leave, Mikey, just wait right there. They also have it on this door as well.
That's really nice.
Now, let's go back to the atrium. Now, we have two extremely spacious guest suites on this side and walkway that takes you to the outdoor patio. Again, shared by these two guest suites. Let's start right here. So this door opens up to the first one. What I like about this room is a concrete wall complemented with this oak paneled wall. AC diffuser over there is nicely recessed in, king size bed, and just like the primary bedroom, the wall behind the bed is not connecting to the exterior wall, so you have one entrance point to the bathroom from that side and one entrance point from here. And of course we have the glass walls opening up to the patio, and this door takes you to the bathroom. Right here we have the walk-in shower. They did a half clear, half frost glass for privacy. Beautifully tiled in, shampoo and edge, chrome fixtures. And between the vanity setup and the walk-in shower, we have the water closet. And water closet, you can actually close it off with these glass barn doors. Mikey, can we pan up to the ceiling? I love how they tucked in the track design into the ceiling so it looks more seamless. Now, double vanity design. We have the Corian countertops. Again, that seamless transition, LED lit mirror, gorgeous bedroom. Now, let's go back out. Of course, we have the walk-in closets on this wall. Now, I wanna take you guys out to the outdoor patio space between these two guest suites. This door opens up. We have this walkway here with a water feature, and there you go. Now, same exposed concrete walls are also here. Again, we have the same holes for the steel rods, that industrial look, and it takes you out to this patio space. We have the same limestone floors that we saw in the backyard also here. That sliding glass door opens up from the first guest suite, and right here we have the second guest suite. Nice patio space, and even from this level, you get amazing views of the hillside all the way to the city and the ocean. Yeah. Now, let me take you guys back in. All right, let me hold the door for you guys. Now let's go check out the second guest suite, which is right here. Another spacious room, and again, we have the concrete wall, oak panel back wall, king size bed here, built-in closets on the other side, and just like the other guest suite, floor to ceiling glass doors that open up to the patio space that we just toured. And Mikey, let's actually show the automatic shades here. So we have shades and blackouts, and it's just a nice touch.
Yeah, it's really nice to have. We always get these comments, people asking how you're supposed to get any sleep in these glass houses or modern homes around the hills, but this is the answer.
Well, there you go. Also, smart developers always leaves a gap between the glass doors and the ceiling, so you can put one of these automatic shades in. They're just a nice amenity to have.
For sure.
All right, now let's go check out the bathroom. Just like the other guest suite as well, we have two openings that leads you to the bathroom. Pocket door is here, there you go. And going in, this one also has a double vanity with Corian countertops, LED lit mirror, water closet in the middle, and a walk-in shower. Now, let's go back to the atrium and continue our tour. The room next door is where we have the gym. Lightly staged with the gym equipment. I really like the Zen Garden that they have at the end of the room. We're gonna go there in a minute. But first, to seal this room off of the atrium, you actually have these pocket doors closing it off. You can see the tracks on the floors as well as the ceiling here, and they're automatic. Now, same concrete floors continue here. Mikey, there's a difference between these two walls. These are straight off the forms, and you can see the holes for the seal rods. But right here, they actually smoothed it out a little bit and gave it a texture. So because they have these LED lightings down below, you can actually see all the texture.
Yeah, it looks really nice. I guess we have that on the opposite wall by the bedrooms as well.
Exactly. And the skylight that I showed upstairs at the office or behind the back of the home, you can see it from here, bringing natural light, allowing natural light to come into this room from the both sides.
Yeah, it's really cool.
And to elevate the lighting, they also have these LED tracks kind of around the edges of the room. Now, continuing this way, this whole section is clad with the same oak panels. We have a pocket door right here opening up to, I want to say, your second spa. This is the steam room clad with mosaic tiles. They don't have a light above because for longevity reasons, all that steam can rot out a light fixture pretty quickly. And right on the other side, check this out. Mikey, why don't you go inside? Dry sauna with a pink Himalayan salt wall.
Yeah, this is really cool. Just the color of the light in here is just really nice as well.
That's a unique touch. Yeah, I honestly don't know the purpose of that. It just looks good.
Yeah, I don't know. I see a lot of people using salt lamps. Maybe it's the same kind of thing.
Maybe.
Yeah. What about this thing behind you over here?
That's a DreamPod sensory deprivation tank. This is a really unique amenity, I want to say. I've seen this on another house. You basically fill this in with water and you float inside.
Yeah, it's like really salty water, so you float, and it basically just like deprives you of all your senses, exactly what it sounds like. So some people use it, like Richard Feynman used it as a way to hallucinate without actually taking drugs. He was a famous physicist, but like it's just really, really cool, yeah.
I did not know that. Yeah. This is the second time I'm seeing this. I saw it in another house in Hollywood Hills.
Yeah.
And the same skylight detail also continues here. Now, going to the other side, just like the entry, we also have pocket doors here, sealing it off. And we have the den here. This room also serves as your family room on the lower level. Same concrete walls continue. We have the skylight here as well. Zen garden, TV setup, massive U-shaped couch. Good room to entertain. And if you want to close it off from the entry, we have the pocket doors also here with the tracks on the bottom and top. Now, as we continue, Mikey, actually, can we pan up to this side for a second? These oak panels that we saw off of the entry, again, with these really unique patterns, and we have two more rooms behind these walls. You can actually see the glass walls behind it. We actually have a door right here. Again, we're going to tour that in a minute. But now we have two more doors in front of us, and these are the two guest suites we have on this level. Now, let's start with this one. We have the king-size bed situated on the left, seating area in front, and this is a cool detail. So we're at the lower level right now. To allow natural light to come in, they have this opening here, and they tapered it off nicely, put a little Zen garden there, and check this out. There's a pocket glass door here opening up, allowing a ton of natural light, and also, Del, can we hit it? Because we don't have the space on the inside, they have this outside screen here, blackout. And Mikey, can you go a little bit more back? Let's pan up to the ceiling. That's a skylight off of entry, bringing natural light to the lower level. Amazing. The attention to detail for natural light in this house is simply stunning. Now, of course, this one also has its own bathroom, and we have the same clad that we saw on the exterior of the home, bronze finish. They also use it for these door jams. Opens up to the full bathroom, double vanity setup, water closet, and a spacious walk-in shower. Now, as we go back, let's go check out the other guest suite. We are back at the atrium here, and the room next door is the second guest suite on this side. Again, same concrete floors continues. This one actually gets a desk setup, but before we tour the bedroom, come on in this way. We have the bathroom here, toilet setup, walk-in shower. Mikey, let's pan up to the ceiling. Another skylight off of the entry, bringing natural light, and a floating vanity design here. Now, as we go in to the bedroom, these polyform built-in closets are simply amazing. Look at the way these doors open and close. Of course, closets are nicely dressed in. Everything, every little detail about this home. King-size bed here. Of course, this room is really spacious, but this one probably works perfect as a maid's quarters because it has a door that opens up to the driveway. So it has its own secondary exterior access, which is awesome. That's the driveway right there. And this room also gets a skylight, which is right here with the same sage glass that is dimmable, and you can control it right here. Now, let's go back out to the atrium. And this is the last hallway, and that leads us to the covered carport. And this door right here opens up to the service kitchen. Now, this kitchen is so impressive. I feel like it's almost better than the showroom kitchen that we toured on the upstairs. I mean, it has everything. Same polyform cabinets are also here. Uppers are brought up all the way to the ceiling. We have these base cabinets, Miele gas cooktop, marble countertops, and they use the same marble as a backsplash as well. We have the LED lighting, these uplifting cabinets. Corners are for the pantries. We have the microwave and the oven set up here. First sink on the service kitchen. There's another one on the other side. And Mikey, can we get a close up? We have this commercial faucet here. Check these out. Never seen these before. We kind of have these small storage spaces here.
What is this for?
I honestly don't know. I guess you store your washware and all that stuff.
Yeah, or maybe it's like, you know, it's kind of annoying to have forks and knives clanking around in the sink. Maybe you put them like in there.
Maybe. Let us know in the comment section if you know what that is for.
Yeah.
And the island setup has a bit of a seating area there. Continuing, panel freezer, fridge, these drawer setups on the bottoms. There you go. More built-ins, and cabinets pretty much continue here with the same countertops, backsplash, secondary sink. Check this out. Dishwasher number one, dishwasher number two, and we have the dumbwaiter here going up to the main kitchen on the second floor. It's a nice convenience to have. You cook something here, you can bring it up, vice versa.
Yeah, I feel like I would spend more of my time cooking in here. It's feels a little bit more industrial and
more focused.
Yeah, it's less like a showroom, and it's more like, you know, get some cooking knocked out in here.
I like that. I agree. Also, we have that hallway opening up to the carport, so if you have caterers come in, chefs come in, they can come in from there, come straight to the service kitchen. Now, we have these two wine enclosures. If I can open up the doors, there you go. First one right here, temperature controlled.
Nice and cool in there.
Exactly. We have the second one right here. In total, they hold 352 bottles, and this is a cool one. Let's see the swing. Opens back to the atrium. How cool is that, right?
I love those doors.
Exactly, behind these oak panels. And they also have these recessed in handles here as well. Now, we have one more room to see, and that's right here. Let's go take a look. It's the laundry room. We specifically wanted it toward this room because it's so spacious, the amount of cabinets in this room. You have this massive island design with a sink right in the center, all these base cabinets, uppers with LED lighting brought all the way to the ceiling. I feel like this is one of the most impressive laundry rooms we toured on this channel. What do you think, Mikey?
Easily one of the most impressive laundry rooms we've toured on this channel, but I don't feel like it's just a laundry room. I feel like it's like a utility room. You keep any extra supplies you have in here, from light bulbs to towels to, you know, anything you might need throughout the rest of the house, you store it in here. So yeah, it's a cool room.
I agree, it serves a good function. And washer and dryer here, desk setup. I mean, what can I say? For a house this impressive, it's nice to have a laundry room this size. And that wraps our tour on the lower level. Now let's go back to the atrium. I feel like the lower floor is just as impressive as top floor. And we're back at the atrium. Now, we won't be doing justice to a home like this unless we spend a few more hours here, wait for the sun to go down so we can see this house at dusk. All right, everyone, that's it for the tour. In summary, this property has stunning architecture. I love all the wood, steel, and concrete elements. We have walls of glass, cantilever, 106-foot infinity edge pool, and these amazing views. For that, I want to congratulate Zoltan Pally for doing a phenomenal job with the design, Dugali Oberfeld with the flawless execution, and lastly, I want to thank the listing agents, Mauricio Umansky, James Harris, and David Parnes for allowing us to tour their amazing listing. More information about the property will be down in the description, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give us a like. If you have any questions or input, as always, leave us a comment down below. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you guys next week.